It was known as the East West Gathering. Now 50 years have passed, 50 years have passed. उस घटना को तो उसकी सुवर्ण जयंती मनाई जा रही है. तो आई थॉट आई विल जस्ट से वेरी सम इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग्स ऑन दैट मैटर अबाउट दैट इवेंट. नाउ दिस इवेंट टुक प्लेस इन मेरा इन ग्रुप पुणा एंड देयर वाज लॉट ऑफ सिंगिंग देयर. सो नाउ यू कैन गेट सम ग्लिम्स. This young artist is also trying to perform. And I am sure Baba will be very happy. ये बाबा ने जो वहाँ पर प्रोग्राम ऑर्गेनाइज किया था तो उसके पहले से तैयारी शुरू हो गई. 1962 नवंबर में ये प्रोग्राम हुआ तो 1961 से इसकी तैयारी चल रही थी और उसके बारे में बाबा ने एक सर्कुलर भी निकाला था. पहले बाबा ने ये कहा कि दिस विल बी फॉर वन वीक पर सर्कुलर और देयर दैट दिस विल बी फॉर वन वीक एंड बाबा वांटेड द प्रोग्राम मेनली फॉर द वेस्टर्न बिकॉज बाबा हैड नॉट गिवन दर्शन ही वाज इन सिचुएशन बट हिज हेल्थ वॉज नॉट गुड. बट इन स्पाइट ऑफ दैट इल हेल्थ बाबा डिसाइडेड दैट ही शुड गिव दर्शन एंड दिस दर्शन वुड बी हेल्ड इन पूना बिकॉज पूना इज मोर कन्वीनियंट दैट अमन नगर पर्टिकुलरली फॉर वेस्टर्नर्स. वेस्टर्न जो इंग्लैंड अमेरिका ऑस्ट्रेलिया या ईरान या जापान से जो आएंगे उनके लिए पूना ज्यादा कन्वीनियंट था इसलिए बाबा ने पूना में प्रोग्राम किया. और कहाँ पर किया? गुरुप्रसाद. गुरुप्रसाद ये जो है ये बहुत बड़ा पैलेस था. वेरी बिग पैलेस एंड दैट पैलेस बिलोंग टू द महारानी ऑफ बड़ौदा. महारानी ऑफ बड़ौदा वॉज वॉज हर नेम शांता देवी गायकवाड़. बड़ौदा इज वेरी वेल्दी स्टेट वन ऑफ द रिचेस्ट स्टेट इन इंडिया एंड महारानी वॉज द क्वीन मदर. दैट मीन्स ऑल द फंड्स फॉर द बड़ौदा स्टेट फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया वुड कम टू शांता देवी एंड शी वुड डिस्ट्रीब्यूट. सो इन 1951 बाबा वॉन्टेड सम प्लेस इन पूना फॉर कमिंग एंड स्टेइंग देयर ड्यूरिंग द समर मंथ बिकॉज इन मेहराबाद एंड मेहराबाद summer month is very hot. And then Baba used to go at that time in Mahabaleshwar or Sata. But then eventually he wanted a place in Poona. So later was sent to here in Poona to Meherabad Jassawala and to Bhargava Gadekar. They find suitable place for them. So accordingly they contacted the Maharani of Baroda through one Mr. Madhura Rasti. Who was a very wealthy person in Poona and the whole of Raftabad is named after him. So you can imagine how wealthy he must have been. Still we have got that Rastewala there. So through him, Maharani was approached and Maharani was very kind to give that palace for Baba's work. So this is Maharani of Baroda along with Meherabad. This is a part of. So I thought I will just show you some pictures also. So Maharani was asked that can she give this Guruprasad for Baba darshan. And she said okay. Then Baba said simply okay is not important. Simply okay will not do. I have got my conditions. So Baba ne apne conditions rakhi. Kya thi Baba ki conditions for Maharani? Number one, Baba can come any time and go any time. From Guruprasad and nobody would ask any question to Baba. What was the second condition? Guruprasad should be made exclusively for Baba. Nobody else should come and stay in Guruprasad at that time when Baba is staying in Guruprasad along with the Raven Mandali and Men Mandali. And what was the third condition? Third condition was that even if Maharani of Baroda wants to come to Poona for having Baba's darshan, she is welcome to come to Poona for having Baba's darshan, but she will have to stay at some other place. And from there she has to come for Baba's darshan. So these were the conditions. And when these conditions were given, then Maharani was so kind, he said, Baba, I agree to all your conditions. So at this point, what do we have to say?
Baba.
So this was the palace. And what? How can I describe that palace? It was one of the most beautiful palaces in India. It was named Guruprasad, not because of Meher Baba's connection with Maharani of Baroda, but because of Maharani of Baroda's connection with her own Guru, before she came to Dava's contact. So when this palace was created, it was named as Guruprasad by Maharani Shankar Devi. It was a very big estate, starting from the Bun Garden Road, extending right up the river. It's about 2-3 acres of land. On that land, at the center place, this palace was built. And this palace was covering several thousand square yards of area. There was a big central hall in the center. There were two wings on either side. And then there was, behind the central hall, there was this dining room for Baba. And then on one side, the ladies would stay, and on the other side, the men mandali would stay. On the first floor, there was also a big room in which Bhautosu was asked to stay. The entire palace has flooring of marble. And this marble was brought from Europe. And there were many statues in the palace. And these statues were made of serpentine marble, green colored marble. That was also brought from abroad. There was a big porch. And part of the porch you can see in Guruprasad Memorial even today. Have you visited Guruprasad Memorial?
Yes.
So please do. Is it Guruprasad? It is in Poona. So that porch is a 1/10 of the original porch. So you will get some idea. The original porch was 10 times bigger than the present one. And Baba would come there and stay. And he would be so happy there. Now coming back to this program. Baba sent circular to all the people to come. But instead of 1 week, the program was curtailed for 4 days. And earlier the program was held in the month of May. But Baba later on changed, because May would be very hot, particularly for the Westerners. Therefore Baba was so kind and he changed it to November. In November the climate is pleasant, and 4 days. The dates were fixed for 2nd, 3rd and 4th of November 1962. Here is a letter which I have got, which is signed by the Maharani of Baroda, that how she remembers Baba and how Guruprasad was gone. And she was so fond of Baba and she has totally surrendered to Baba. So, letters started receiving from abroad, we are coming, we are coming, we are coming. And the circular was also sent to all over India. So they also said that we are coming, we are coming. So for accommodating all the people, at the backyard of the palace, there was a big ground. And in that ground, a big pandal was erected. And that pandal had a capacity of 5,000 people. Can you imagine? And that pandal was all decorated with silk cloth, different colored silk cloth. And in front of the palace, there was a big garden. And in the garden, there were flower beds on either side. And in the center of the garden, there was a big fountain, water was pouring out of that fountain. And in the main gate of Guruprasad was a very ornate gate made of wrought iron. So that is how I can briefly describe. You must have seen the palace, the photograph of the palace. This is the photograph of Guruprasad Palace, in front of which Baba is standing. That is how the Guruprasad Palace was. The pillars were such beautifully decorated marble, and it is a special European architecture called Corinthian architecture. So at the top of the pillar you will find the flowers. So you can see some of those pillars here in this column. So on the day was approaching, and people started pouring in from all over. What was the position of Digambar at that time? What was my position at that time? I was only about, I don't know, 52 or 25, 26 years old. And I was an officer in Oil and Natural Gas Commission working in Gujarat. But when the circular I received, I said that I am fitted to work as a volunteer. So I was accepted as a volunteer. And what was my duty? Because I was familiar with the Westerners, I was given to attend, a duty to attend to the Westerners. Their transport, their accommodation, and bringing to Guruprasad and taking back. I have been volunteering other programs also. So all of us, we came, our family came from Gujarat to Poona. My mother and my sister, elder sister, myself, and when she so all of us came, and then in addition to being the volunteer for this, I was also having a camera, and with that camera I used to take pictures of Baba and the crowd, and those pictures are still there with me. I shall show you. In addition to that, there was third duty for me. So what was that duty? Poona Bhajan Mandali was in big form. We were going very strong, Madhusudan, Subhadra and all of us. So I was also a member of the Poona Bhajan Mandali. So in that capacity we had to sing before Baba. So you can imagine, I was doing three roles at the same time: volunteer, photographer and Bhajan Mandali. And when Baba came, on the first day the program started. But what happened on the 31st night? There was heavy rain. All the pandal was ready, the chairs were placed, and there was so heavy rain that in the pandal there was all mud and slush up to ankle depth. And the manager of the pandal, he came before Baba and he started weeping. "Baba, what is this? How can you hold the program? There is all mud, and how can I keep the chairs in the mud?" And if Indians hote to achha hai, agar foreigners log aa rahe to unke liye kaise chalega? Baba said, "Don't worry." What did he do? Overnight, about 15-20 truckloads of earth was brought, and it was spread on the ground, and the ground became without any mud or without any slush, and it was all very nice. On the 1st of March, westerners came, hundreds of them came, and before that on the 29th, one westerner came, and he had Baba darshan, and his name was Tom, and Baba told to Tom, "Function is starting on the 1st. You have come on the 31st, 29th, so you have done the ice breaking. You have started the party. Jaisa introduction hota hai na." So Baba said that 29th, you have done the ice breaking. So hundreds and thousands of people came. They came from all over the west, and they were asked to sit in the front rows. Indians, kya karega? Morning program. Morning program only for the westerners. Afternoon program for mixed Easterners and Westerners. So Baba came and he was sitting. At that time, Baba's health was not good. If you looked at Baba, you would feel so sorry. And I was also feeling sorry because he was sick. He was ill. That beauty and that splendor was not there. But when he came for the darshan program, on the first morning, people were stunned because that glory was already there, back. And then he was meeting all the people. Afternoon, the program went on in the morning. There was singing in the morning. The Sufis came. Sufis came along with their leader, who was known as Murshida. And who was the Murshida at that time? Murshida Ivy Deuce. She was the Murshida. And she came. And then morning program was there. There was singing. And there was dancing. And there was one American Baba lover who was a doctor. His name was Harry Canmore. He was a chiropractor. By just touching your nerve, he will tell what is wrong with you. But what was his specialty? He was totally blind. He could not see anything. And he was so fond of Baba. And Baba asked him to sing the Parvat Digar prayer. And then Baba would tell Harry Canmore to sing Parvat Digar prayer. Harry Canmore would start, "Oh, Parvatiga!" like that. And everybody would be stunned. So he had that thundering voice. And in that voice, the prayer was sung and Baba was ready for hearing the darshan. So this went on till the morning. In the afternoon, there was break. And again, after the break, all of the session. It was open program for the Easterners and Westerners together. So there was a lot of crowd, and the panda was full to the capacity. And this is the picture of the panda, which is taken by whom? Your one and only. Okay. So this is all these color photographs, unfortunately, the black and white. But we'll see one day the color slides also.
They look better this
way. And then Baba was there. And this is the picture of Baba. This is very beautiful picture of Baba. In color it so, looks so nice. So that is how he was seated on the throne. As if it was a throne. And as an emperor sits on the throne, Baba was sitting and people were taking his time. What a sight it was. And that day, how many people took Baba's darshan? 5,000! Can you imagine? Everybody, and Baba was so particular that he embraced those people. He gave his love to all those people. Look at the compassion of the Lord. And the program, first day's program, on the 1st of November, ended with Arati by Nadusu. And what was that Arati? Divyasanasana Paramalayaganaya. And before that I forgot, for the welcome song, Parishudan composed one English song. And what was that song? We welcome. That was the song. And we sang that song in full throat. And Baba was very happy. And the Westerners, they started clapping. Oh, this Indian musical group singing Western song. And such a nice music. So give them a clap. So that was the first thing. Then on the second day, what happened? In the morning, there was again Westerners gathering and beautiful program. And Baba explained some philosophical things. Baba explained a big chart on the wall, and the title of the chart was Four Journeys. And in that it is described that how the soul travels in different parts, what are the different parts of that journey. And there are four parts of journey. And Baba described how the human soul from its own original condition as God, as an individualized soul, how it progresses with the grace of the master in the spiritual path, and how ultimately that individualized soul, it becomes God himself. So that is the end of the journey. So in short, that whole journey chart was explained, and how the soul passes to the home point, the Jivan Mukta stage, God realized, Sadguru, and again in the Paramatma stage. That was the story. Then what happened in the afternoon? There was shortage of chairs. People more and the chairs less. So what is to be done? Baba said, bring 1,000 chairs more. So 1,000 more chairs were brought on the second day, and they were placed. And all the people, they sat, and then Baba gave in the afternoon a beautiful message. What was the title of that message? My children. My children, it is such a beautiful message. If you find time, please read that. And it was the first time that we experienced that Baba is addressing all of us as my children. Means he is from his state of the infinite consciousness and infinite bliss and infinite knowledge. From that state, he is addressing all of us as my children. And that was a beautiful message given to all the children. And there were the children from the west and the children from the east. Andhra se aaye hue children the, or Japan se aaye hue children the. There were children from England, and there were children from Iran. And there were young children and old children. There were ladies' children and gents' children. So all the children were there. And they were all children of the Lord. And he addressed to them for the first time. That is the first time I heard any message from Baba beginning my chant. So that is a wonderful message. Then again, at the end of the second day, there was Arati by Madhusudan. Madhusudan and the bhajan party was given strict order that whenever the program ends, first, second, third, fourth, it will end with the Arati by the Poona bhajan mandali. So Poona bhajan mandali ke caller there are type of Baba ko apne bahut bula ke Baba, you are so grateful, you are so grateful. Program khatam ho gaya aur log jaane ke liye lage wapas. Itne message aa gaya Andhra se, Guntur district, one small village, Sirala. Sirala se villagers aaye very poor farmers. No money to travel and stay for many days in Poona. Only money for one day. So only they came for one day for Baba Darshan. But program was over. 6 o'clock, gates closed. So they waited and they went. They had come all the way from Chirala, thousands of kilometers. And they went to the railway station to catch the returning train. And Baba, who knows everything, he just inquired, has anybody come? As if he did not know. He said, yes Baba, some villagers had come, but the program was closed, it was lost, and so we told him that you come tomorrow. Baba was so furious. Baba said, they are my lovers, they have come. But you ask them to come tomorrow. So immediately on the railway station, on the platform, who was sent? Balnathu. With what message? Unko bolo, ki ruk jao yahan par. They were ready to go back. Because no money. Baba ne Balnathu sabko bola, kuch bhi karo, unka raat bhar rehne ka intezam karo, and next day ask them to come. The program starts at 9 o'clock, but for them, I will start the program at 6:30. So, send them the message. So the poor farmers of Shirala, they slept there on the platform, in the chawl tree, in the dharmashala. And next morning, they got up at 5, they took the bath and came for the darshan of the Lord of the Lakes. And there they were in Guruprasad. And 6:30 sharp was on the chair. So that was the darshan. On the second day, on the third day, because the westerners were to come at 9 o'clock. So Baba ne wohi slot khali tha, wo unko de diya, Kerala ke logon ke liye. What happened on the third day? Every day is a beautiful day. And every day is a memorable day. On the third day, there was music. And that music was such a divine music. I will not go into details, but great singers like Pandit Vinayak Rao Patwardhan, who was awarded Padma Bhushan by the government of India, he was asked to sing for 1 hour, complete session in the morning, for particularly for Westerners. Why? Because Baba wanted to give a glimpse of the Indian classical music to the Westerners. Because they had no idea. And Pandit Vinayak Rao Patwardhan, such a singer, when he went to Russia in the delegation for singing Indian classical music, and that Prime Minister of Russia, Nikita Khrushchev, you might have heard, Nikita Khrushchev, Khrushchev was in the audience. So after Vinayak Rao Patwardhan sang, Khrushchev came to Vinayak Rao Patwardhan, he asked him to open your mouth, and he opened his mouth, and he looked inside. इसके गले में कोई मशीन बिठाए क्या? That was Vinayak Rao Patwardhan. And he sang this song. And there was such a beautiful song. And there was also skits. On the fourth day, on the last day, there was also music. And Madhusudan had composed a song. Which was that song? Mehre Ek Ho Mehre Nitya. And that song, Baba had asked that song also should be sung. So that song was also beautiful. Then there was Kawali session. Kawal from Jaipur had come. Then Kawal from Ahmednagar had come. Habib Kawal. They performed Kawali before Baba. And Lata Limaye, who is now in Poona, she also sang before Baba. The fourth time. And that is how the program came to an end. So this, in brief, then on the what happened on the third day, Baba gave another message, and that message was for the workers. Workers ko bula Baba ne, ki Baba ka kaam kaise karna chale. How the workers should work for me without having any personal benefit or anything for the self, they must do Baba's work totally in a selfless manner. And then on the third day, what was there in the afternoon? Bhaskar Raju had come from Andhra Pradesh. And Bhaskar Raju was known for performing. What did he perform? Burakata. Burakata, you know, sir? Burakata, you know. So 150th performance of Burakata was performed on the 3rd of November before Baba in Guruprasad. That was the third day. And on the fourth day, Baba said, again we started early in the morning. So when the program started on the fourth day, 6 o'clock in the morning. Baba was there again, 6 o'clock. And at the end of the day, Baba said that today I have embraced 7,000 people. Can you imagine the energy of Baba at that time, and who was having such a bad health? I did not tell about the bad condition of him. Baba was already suffering from very high diabetes and blood urea and so many, and the pain in the this because of the fracture, compound fractures, and he could not stand also. But because of that, Baba loved for all the people. This program was such a wonderful program. In the end, on the fourth day, Baba's universal message was read by Don Stevens. Don Stevens, you might have heard his name. And then, when the program was concluded with Baba's Arati, and all the people started to leave, what did Baba say? Baba said, all of you, take me with you. I repeat, all of you, take me with you. What a wonderful one-liner. सभी लोग घर जा रहे हैं, मगर घर जाते समय आप सबको सब मुझे अपने साथ लेके जाइए. That was the end of the program. Thereafter, two three important things happened. I just tell very quickly. On the fifth, all the Westerners went for. There was final meeting with the Westerners. Then there was a skit by the Sufis on the fifth. There was a short drama. And what happened? Well, doctor came with a stethoscope. And the nurse, they were all Sufis dressed as doctor, and they came to Baba, and Baba was sitting, and stethoscope he put to Baba's chest. And then he said, and then that doctor, he made a very, very sorrowful face. Then everybody is asking, doctor, what is your diagnosis? Then the doctor says, the condition of the patient is very bad. What is wrong with him? His heart has become very, very big. His heart has become very big because of giving constant grace to all the people. That was the diagnosis of the doctor. Then the people said, doctor, you suggest the medicines. Then the medicine was suggested by the doctor. And what was the medicine? Baba was asked that he should increase his dose of darshan. That was the medicine prescribed by the doctor. So that was a very funny thing, and then people very, and one of the patients came, what was the age of that person? 90 years. And that lady, her name was Ruth White, Baba told her on the last day that you are my soldier. Look at the courage and patience. On the 6th, the Westerners visited Meherabad, Meherabad and all that, because I had to go also along with them. On the 7th, they visited Panjrani, Tiger Valley. Gathering. So I thought that I will share it, because this is going to be one of the presentations there. So those